What's up, everyone? In today's video, we're going over how to verify a Google My Business without a physical address or postcard. Now, I'm going to be going over an overview of different ways, different tactics, things that I have experience with, because right now, Google has had some algorithm updates and also some Google My Business updates. There's a lot of accounts being suspended. Maybe some of you are even coming and finding my video because you have some suspended accounts. And unfortunately, even some real business accounts are getting affected by this update. It's okay, you can contact Google though and sort that all out and they will fix your account. I've had to do that in the past as well. But today, you really wanna learn, especially if you're in my Rank and Rent course, then you know that we're big on how to get Google My Business listings verified so that we can leverage them to generate phone calls and traffic for our businesses. So we're gonna go over that. We're gonna talk a little bit about the updates, the pros and cons. But before I jump into this overview, if you're new to my channel, I'm James Cook. I make business tutorials right over the shoulder. I also give business advice from experience, and I talk about personal development and growth. So if you like any of that type of stuff, then definitely click the subscribe button and the bell icon now so you don't miss any of my weekly videos where I always try to add a lot of value. So we're gonna jump into this now. And again, we're talking about verifying a Google My Business without a physical address or postcard. Now, there's three main ways I'm gonna go over this, and some of them are kind of contradicting that statement when I'm saying no physical address or postcard, because in a way, we are going to talk about how you're going to use physical address and postcards, but they're actually not yours. And then there is a solution through services, and I'll link any services and things that I talk about in this video down below in the description so you can check them out, where you don't have to worry about a physical address or postcard at all, and it really does get taken care of for you. So we'll talk about that last, so definitely stay to the end. But the first thing is, when it comes to this topic, is virtual mailbox and address. Now, I used to use this nonstop. I have a lot of business, Google My Businesses, that are still up today, ranking and getting traffic, all from this tactic. It's utilizing and leveraging virtual mailbox services. Now, if you go over to Google and you type in virtual mailbox or virtual address, you're going to see companies like Anytime Mailbox, iPostal. There's a couple other big ones. I've used these companies before in the past, and it used to work great. However, I started really testing and trying to get more addresses verified, and I noticed some hiccups. There was a few of the listings that right away were getting suspended, and I want to bring that to your attention because this used to work great, but just like anything else, when you start sharing in public everything and the more people start catching on and doing it, it usually comes to an end, unfortunately. That's why in my Rank and Rent website course, and some of you might be in there, you know we really try to keep some testing inside that group, and we really keep things confidential so that we can share it in only that group. Now, if you're not in my Rank and Rent website, that's all about local SEO clients and also ranking and building assets and renting them out, and we go over obviously Google My Business stuff. If you want to check that out, I'll leave the link in the description as well so you can check that out. But again, virtual addresses and mailboxes are powerful, but I stay away from the big companies that are doing this now. And I feel Google really found out all the addresses that they're renting out, because this is how it works. So you don't need a physical address, but this company will let you rent a physical address in one of their locations. It's a great concept. So how that works is, let's say I wanted an address in San Diego for my plumbing business. I would go over to Anytime Mailbox, I'd go over to San Diego, and there's an address that I could use and rent out from them. How I would do that is I pay them a monthly fee. I think I paid between $10 or $20 monthly fee. I got my address, I went over to Google, I set up my Google My Business, I sent the postcard to them, they forward it to me, or they would take a picture and email it to me, and now I have the code that I need and I verify my address. So I'm using their address, they get the postcard. It's a really great service. The problem is, all the addresses that they're renting out, a lot of people are going to start using similar addresses, and I think Google was able to blacklist many of these services. And you can see one of the emails I got back from Google when I was asking why are they suspending my listing right here. You see that, their response is, they can tell it was a virtual address. That's what made me realize that they know these type of addresses and they're analyzing this stuff and they're really making adjustments. They're making it harder. So the best thing that you definitely want though is a postcard. Unfortunately, it's not what everyone wants to hear, but I realize a lot of the listings that are staying strong got postcards. And these did count still because a postcard was still being sent out, right? A postcard was being sent out to a real address, but now that it got abused, that tactic, and all those addresses got abused, you gotta try to stay away from these big companies that have these websites with so many addresses that everyone's using. However, what I did find was I really started doing a lot of research and I found someone that was renting out a little mailbox in a store that was not too far from me and they had no other mailboxes anywhere else in the US. It was very hard to find them. And when I verified my business through there, it worked. Okay, so there is still hope for this. The virtual mailbox, it's finding a small store that has mailboxes that they'll rent to you, almost like a UPS box. But again, you cannot use a UPS box, just so you know. That does not work, a PO box does not work. But these are set up like physical addresses and they get your mail and they'll just scan it and forward it to you via email. And boom, you have your postcard code and you can log into the back end of your Google My Business and verify. So there is still hope with this method. I'm still testing some things out and I also share that in my Rank and Rent, the Digital Real Estate Secrets Facebook group. But you just gotta be careful of where you're getting your addresses from. Now maybe some of the addresses on these big sites still work, but the few that I tested, I got the same email back. So I know there's something going on. So I try to stay away from the big companies that are renting out all these mailboxes that could easily be found by everyone and then used and just end up being blacklisted. So what I do now is I really try to go in and look for small companies or smaller stores that have rental space that I can just rent for a month or two to get my postcard. So it's really thinking outside of the box. But again, with that method, yes, you don't need your own physical address, but you're leveraging someone else's and then they send the postcard there and they scan it and send it to you, or they'll mail it to you. Now, the second thing I'm gonna go over is Craigslist. Now, I wanna make it very clear, I do not use this method. However, I do know people that are close to me that use this method and it works. What they do is they go on Craigslist, they list a gig or a service, and they pretty much will list that in a city that they want to be in. Again, if I wanted my plumbing company in San Diego, I would go over to Craigslist San Diego, I would post a gig saying that I'm looking for someone to receive a piece of mail for me. If you're interested, I'll pay you to receive this piece of mail at your physical address. Please message me. When they message you, you explain to them what you're trying to do. You can give them 50% up front, and then once they send you the postcard, a picture of the postcard, and you verify it, everything goes through, you send them the other 50%. That's what I was told that one of my buddies was doing in order to get his addresses. Again, more of this coming out, more people doing it, it can also become something that gets blacklisted, unfortunately. Okay, so that is a method. Again, I don't use that method, but people are using that method with some success. Now, the last thing that I know everyone's gonna be excited about is actually a service that does this for you. Now, there was recently a Google My Business update, and when this update happened, again, a lot of listings were suspended. Even the service providers that were building these listings are having some trouble now. I reached out to 5 service providers over the last couple months and was getting some listings made. Now these are 5 different service providers. Now I'm going to put a link down to one or two of them that I trust that in the last 2 months actually built me successful listings. And I'm not going to list the ones that I did not end up using. Either they did not end up replying back, I ordered, I had to get my money back and they didn't reply back, or they ended up telling me it's not working anymore, there's the way they were doing their service. Now, a lot of them were able to also do this thing called instant verification. Instant verification, they were doing that without a postcard, but I feel that postcards are very key now. I almost want someone who uses a service where they get a postcard and a verification code because it's going to a physical address and I think Google trusts that more right now. That is my opinion and coming from my experience of what I think is going on there. And I think that's one of the things. So I always say postcard, is key. Now, some of these services will offer you that. They'll say, we're gonna take care of everything. Just tell us the city you wanna be in. Purchase our service. It's usually around $120 to sometimes $250 to get one of these business listings, but it's well worth it if it gets done right. So I would purchase this service. I tell them I wanna be in San Diego. They would set up the service. I give them all my business information and they take care of everything and they verify it. It becomes completely verified. You don't need a physical address and you don't need a postcard. They take care of it all. Now, a lot of these services are having problems. So no matter what, even anything you see me talk about or link down below, please message them. Message them on their Facebook page or email them right from their website and ask them questions and concerns, and also ask them if they're still able to provide this service even with the recent updates. And if they get back to you and say, yes, you can place your order, then you should be good to go. A lot of them give 30-day guarantee also, so you can always get your money back. It's definitely an option right now that is great, but again, the more you share, the more people jump on, the more people there's awareness of where it's going and where it's coming from, the more likely things can get shut down. So I'm gonna share that as well. Now, there is some things we're also testing out, and again, people in my Digital Real Estate Secrets Facebook group know this, people that are part of my Rank and Rent course understand this. So we wanna keep some things confidential, but I also wanna give you value and share with you some of the things that you can do right now, because I get a lot of messages about this topic now, especially after the recent updates, is how do I get to Google My Business if I'm trying to rank and rent a website and I don't have that physical location? Well, you could check out that service below. You could also dive deep into this and try to find, again, not the big, I wouldn't go with the big companies, try to find a smaller company that could rent space, temporary space, or a mailbox just for you to get a postcard, and just talk, you could call up the service and ask them questions. You could try the Craigslist hack. Again, I don't do that, but you could try that. But the services where someone takes care of it for you is because they have a process in place where, and again, it does take time, but they know how to communicate over to Google that this is a business, it's a real business, we need the postcard sent here, and they go through the whole process and take care of it for you. So it does make everything very easy. You do have to pay for that, but again, it's well worth it in my opinion. So these are the three ways right now that I'm looking at. Remember, postcard is the key. And the number one thing too is once you get your business listing, your Google My Business verified, you want to rank in Google Maps. That's the whole point of this. You want traffic and phone calls coming in, right? Whether it's for your clients or whether it's for your rank and rent or lead generation website. Now it's for your clients. Most of them should have a physical address where they're servicing, or they probably live there, or they have friends and family there. I would leverage those people to definitely make sure you get your postcard, because that's a legitimate business and you won't have any problems getting a postcard and verifying it. But when you're going with lead generation or rank and rent, yes, you have to look at these type of methods to set up your Google My Business. I made a Rank in the Maps video going over once your business listing's verified. I'll link that up here, because once your business is verified, you definitely wanna rank it in the maps. So you can check out that video. I'll also leave that link below. But these are the methods right now that I would go with. Definitely a service, and if there's other service providers, I will share them or maybe update down below. And if some of them aren't working anymore, I'll have me or someone on my team delete it out of my description and swap it out. Or maybe I'll say, hey, DM me and ask me if I still have someone who's doing this service. Again, the more that everything's out there, the more you're doing things, the more people become aware, the more saturated it gets. And then unfortunately, those type of things end up coming to an end. So really what we're trying to do is think outside the box and get a postcard to a physical address. And these are the ways you could do that. Even though it's not your physical address, it's not a postcard coming to you, these are the ways that you can work around that. And again, the best option is if you have the money to try out a service, especially a service that gives a guarantee. So this way, if it doesn't work out, at least you didn't lose out on your money. But again, I had some success with services, and then I had some not so success. And it wasn't the end of the world. I did get my money back. So you have to watch out. There is services out there that are not able to deliver these type of claims that they say. That's why I want you to be careful and make sure you ask questions first. So I hope that added value. If you like this video, please give me the thumbs up. Again, if you're not subscribed, subscribe and share this with anyone you think would help. Anyone that's a local business owner, anyone that is trying to get into rank and rent or lead generation, share this with anyone that's interested in SEO. And again, this is all about how to verify your Google My Business without your own physical address, without getting the postcard to your home or to your office that you don't have. And you can leverage these ways. Check out the service below. Check out the Rank and Rent website course down below. And I'll see you in the next video.